Hello and welcome. I'm Allie. I'm the owner and founder of Goss Legal. As you will notice, I have another amazing attorney with me. Her name is Lindsay Barnes Watkins, and she is one of our associate attorneys. I'm excited to have her here because she's going to answer some fun questions that is going to help our audience. So, first, Lindsay, why don't you introduce yourself and maybe a little bit about where you're from and why you like working with estate planning clients?
Yes, so as Allie mentioned, my name is Lindsay Watkins. I am originally from Nevada, but I have moved all around. I have been an active duty soldier in the Army. I've also been in the California National Guard, and I'm currently a reservist. And my husband is also active duty military. So we have we come from a big military family. We've moved all around, and that's one of the reasons why I enjoy doing a lot of help and advising with soldiers and with veterans.
Nice. Well, thank you for your service, first of all. We always appreciating our service members. And thanks for joining the team. Lindsay has been instrumental in helping us, bring on more clients and service them in a more efficient manner. And she has this great level of expertise. So I thought she could answer a few questions that would help our audience out. The first one is, if you could tell us a little bit about why estate planning is important for veterans.
Estate planning is very important for veterans and service members in general. There are several situations that are unique to active duty service members, and veterans. And there's a multitude of benefits that may be available to veterans that they can plan for if they know about them. There are several other reasons, just in general, why planning estate doing estate planning in and comprehensive estate planning in the military is really important. Do you want me to touch on a couple of those specific things?
Yeah, well, tell me about the V, like the ba V. Oh, my words are gone. The burial benefits, cremation. There's actually some benefits that only VA members get, right?
Yes, so there are service members and veterans that are eligible for certain burial benefits, but there are some monetary benefits or reimbursement benefits that are only available to certain service members and certain veterans and their families. So it's really important to know. I think it's a big misconception. I think that a lot of veterans and their families think that there may be burial benefits that are available that they aren't actually eligible for, while there are other things like getting a flag that can be draped over the casket, having an honor guard or military honors. Those types of things are available. And then also for certain veterans, they can be buried in certain VA national cemeteries. But there has to be space available. And so it's not just something, and it has to be reserved in advance. So it's not something that's just, by virtue of being a veteran that you're entitled to.
Yeah, that sounds a little more complicated than like, oh, thank you for your service. Here's like your package. It sounds like some pre-planning and notifying the family members that like here are the available benefits. Please make sure you don't miss them when I'm gone.
Definitely,
Okay,
definitely.
cool. So that seems important. Tell me a little bit about asset protection. I know that's a buzzword, but especially for veterans, why that might be important for them.
Yeah, so there are some VA benefits that are available to veterans that meet certain eligibility criteria. Specifically, what I'm talking about is what's called VA pension, which is a total misnomer because it's not a pension like we think in the traditional sense. It's a benefit that may be available. There are various levels of pension. The one that is the most commonly known, I think, is aid in attendance. You'll hear the buzzword aid in attendance. And it can be available to veterans to help provide some additional income for long-term care. And again, there are some service requirements to meet eligibility, and then there's income and asset requirements to meet eligibility. And so with some veterans, there is pre-planning that you can do, asset protection planning that you can do in advance, so that down the road you can potentially become eligible for this benefit. So it's important to know it may not be available to certain veterans if they don't do any planning, or at least have, you know, somebody look at it and determine, is this a, you know, is this a proper benefit for you?
Okay. Yeah, that makes sense. Also complicated. I think maybe the VA stuff is complicated, which is why in the office, we traditionally haven't done a lot of that. So it's one of the reasons I was so excited to bring Lindsay on, because she actually has a lot of experience in this area. So if you are hearing this and you're like, oh, I'm a veteran and I don't think I've planned, or my family member hasn't, contact the office. Before we transition out of here, I want to make sure that we talk about service members in particular. I was curious about this before you came to work for me. And I said, well, why would service members want to come to my office? They get a free estate plan. So can you enlighten us on why someone might actually want to come see us, even though they are serving?
Yes. So the military is only going to offer very basic legal assistance services. And so that doesn't always fit for a lot of service members. Especially there are a few instances that I can think of right off the top of my head where I think it's critically important that the service member actually entertain seeing an estate planning attorney. If the service member owns real property in more than one state, or in a state in which they are no longer a resident, that could be grounds for having multiple probates in multiple different places, which can be a huge, huge burden on the family and can easily be resolved with some pretty simple trust planning. Also for special needs, service members who have children or dependents with special needs, it's vitally important to make sure that you're planning for those people, those special needs people, not only for passing on your assets, but also, you know, for survivor benefit pensions and things like that. I've seen, you know, service members who leave it to like a special needs child, and then it will totally mess up their Medi-Cal benefits. So it's just, you know, important to at least in my opinion, to have that service members at least, you know, have their estate plan looked at by an estate planning attorney outside of the military, especially if they need things that are a little bit more advanced than the basic will and, you know, power of attorney that the military provides.
Yeah. So if you are a service member in California, you will probably not like the impact of your plan that has on your family, because in California in particular, we use trust to avoid probate because it's one of the best ways to do that and deal with special needs and a whole host of other things. So, all right, cool. Of course, service members are always welcome, as are our veterans in the office. And just say that and we'll stick you with Lindsay so you guys will have something fun to chat about. Okay, any final tips before we go back and do something else today?
Yes. So one of my final tips is to gather up your documents as it relates to your military service, especially your DD-214s or your report of separation. That's the discharge paperwork that you get. Make sure that it's the actual DD-214s and not just like the discharge certificate that you may get. Because the VA, in order to apply for any of these benefits through the VA, you're going to need your DD-214s or your report of separations. That will have all the criteria on there for eligibility. And I do see sometimes where the veteran will become incapacitated or pass away, and then the family members are trying to find these DD-214s. So it's important to put that all together with your estate planning documents and with your important documents. And if you don't have your DD-214s, you can always request them through the National Archives. It just takes a little bit of time to actually get them. So doing in advance is really helpful for your family and you later on down the road.
A lot of what we do, right, is plan for what happens when we're gone. So it sounds like some of this stuff is just making it easier on the family.
Definitely.
Lifetime and after lifetime. Thank you. I so appreciate the information. I appreciate your expertise and everything you've brought to our team. If you are interested in scheduling consultation, you can call the office 625-6556. That's a 916 because we're based in Northern California. Or email the office at info@gofflegal.com. If you have any questions, we're always here. Thank you, Lindsay, for joining us.
And thank you for having me.
You'll see you later.